Hello, welcome to Retail Outsource. My name is Seb, and today I'm going to show you how to automate pricing on Amazon Seller Central.
E-commerce Beast, quick tips from Retail Outsource.
So to reach the dashboard here, you have to go to Pricing and then click Automate Pricing. And as you can see, there are a lot of different variables that you can do it. So this applies mainly if you are a reseller or retailer and you want to price match it. So I will just show you an example, the scenario that this repricing is best used for. So as you can see, for this item, sand is 16 GB. There are a lot of sellers selling it. You can see. And there is only one seller which got the buy box. And the main factor to get a buy box is the pricing and the fulfillment type. So basically, if you want to get rid of the stock, if you have a lot of in stock, then I will recommend that you go for repricing for that specific ASIN. But if you own that brand and if nobody is selling, you don't have to do the repricing. That's not for you. So I'm just gonna start repricing. So to start with, you have to create a customized pricing rule. And as you can see, we have already some repricing running. So some are to match the buy box price, some are to beat the buy box price, and some are competitive price ruling. That means Amazon will compare the price for the specific item. They will think outside Amazon. You know, this is something we don't have any control. So you have to be really careful with that. And this is free, actually, at this automated pricing from Amazon. It's free. But there are a lot of third-party repricing softwares out there that you can use that have much more functions than this one. With Amazon, you don't have much control, you know, on which item you want to compare. So it's like that side, it's already automated. But to create it, let's start with create customized pricing rule. So there are a few rules that you want to select. So as you can see, competitive buy box, competitive lowest price, or external price based on sale unit. So it's up to you which option you want to select. So in this example, I'm gonna sell competitive buy box. So the main objective is to get the buy box for this reason. So I'm gonna name it as buy box. And I'm gonna click proceed to marketplace selection. So in this case, I want to select the marketplace that the repricing need to be applied. So if you're in the US, it will show three countries, that US, Canada, and Mexico. Because this account is in the Europe, you'll have a lot more accounts. Select the countries that you want to reprice and then click continue. And in this stage, you want to select how you want to reprice. So you can stay below the buy box price at a specified amount. This is, for example, let's assume the item price is 10. And what the system will do is that the system will go and reprice your item to $9.99 if you put here 0.01. So it will beat it by one penny or 1 cent. Okay, below that, again, all the offers from the same ASIN and condition, you know, it doesn't matter. So Amazon will compare all the sellers. I will recommend not to do that, because if you have that Prime badge, if you are doing FBA, then you will have the Prime badge. You don't have to compete with the FBM sellers, fulfilled by merchant sellers. The reason behind is that if you are selling on Prime and if your price is higher, you will still get the buy box because you have that Prime badge. So I want to select specific type of offers and offers with the same fulfillment method. And I only want this offer, it's only for third-party sellers. So if you want to only compete with third-party, you know, sometimes Amazon sell as well. And they are really aggressive with pricing. It's better not to go for repricing with Amazon. And the next option, it will ask if you want to compare the price with outside. So, you know, this is kind of, we don't know exactly how it's going to work. So it's better not to do that because you don't have any control. So I'm going to select no. And the third question is that, do you want to continue repricing if you update your pricing elsewhere in Seller Central? So this is very important. The reason is that you have to put it no. If you put yes, and if you made changes in the pricing, and if that price is below the floor price, then the listing will be suppressed for pricing error. So it's important that you select no, because on the next stage, you have to put a floor price for your item and the ceiling price. That means it will fluctuate within that parameters. So I'm going to select no and save this rule in amazon.co.uk. And next one is to select the SKUs that you want to reprice. So I'm going to proceed to SKU selection. And this is where you put floor price and ceiling price, minimum price and maximum price. So you can put the price like here and just put it and put a maximum price. So you can do, you know, select the listing that you want to reprice. I will always recommend to start with a few listing, test it, how it goes, and then set the pricing. Yeah, that's about it. That's how you do the repricing. We do post a lot of videos about eBay and Amazon. So that's something interests you. Please do subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching.
Once again, if you're selling on Amazon or eBay and have a few questions, you can always book a 30-minute free consultation from the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. Stay safe.